May 30, Thursday of the sixth week of Easter. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "A little while and you will no longer see me, and again, a little while later and you will see me." So some of his disciples said to one another, "What does this mean that he is saying to us, 'A little while and you will not see me, and again a little while and you will see me, and because I am going to the Father'?" So they said, "What is this little while of which he speaks? We do not know what he means." Jesus knew that they wanted to ask him, so he said to them, "Are you discussing with one another what I said, 'A little while and you will not see me, and again a little while and you will see me'? Amen, amen, I say to you, you will weep and mourn while the world rejoices. You will grieve, but your grief will become joy." The Gospel of the Lord. A little while. A little while may refer to chronology, to a short time that Jesus will be taken away from the disciples as he undergoes his paschal mystery. Indeed, they will see him after he rises from the dead, this time as glorified Lord. But mikron may refer to the littleness of something in comparison to a much greater reality that awaits if this is accepted or undertaken. In the context of the Last Supper discourse, it is the passion of Jesus that will soon end in his glorification. By no means does Jesus belittle what he will soon undergo. He is troubled at the coming of his hour, but in the end, in a little while, Jesus goes to what is eternal beyond time, the fellowship with the Father. In turn, the grief that the disciples suffer because Jesus is taken away from them will turn to joy, a joy that no one can take away from them. Paul expresses the same idea when he writes, "I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed for us."